What's going on, beautiful people? What's going on? It is your boy Nico. Welcome back to my channel. So now in this video, what I want to talk about are 7 items that I hate from Hermes. You know what? Hate is a strong word, so I'm going to use the word dislike. So these are the items that I no longer gravitate towards. I don't look for, I don't reach for. I sometimes forget that I have them. They no longer fit into my lifestyle. And you already know I'm all about being transparent with you guys, and I want to tell you guys the real. So I want to just give you guys my best opinion so you guys do not make the same mistake that I did. And I want to make sure you guys get the stuff from Hermes that you really, really do like, because again, these items are pricey and I don't want you wasting your money on items you don't need. So I'm only going to talk about the items that I do have, and I'm only going to talk about 7 of them. You know, I'm not going to trash the whole company because I really do love Hermes. So these items are really hard for me to admit that I do not like. And I find it that a lot of people are saying, I hate this or I hate that. But how can you hate something that you don't own or you do not use? Yeah, you may dislike it. Yeah, you may not like it, but you cannot hate on it or give your full opinion on it. So that's why I'm only going to give my opinions on these items that I do have. Because out there, I find that a lot of people saying, oh, I hate the Birkin, I hate the Kelly, I hate this, and I hate that. And I'm like, how can you hate it if you don't own it? I feel like if you own it, then you really realize what fits into your lifestyle and what doesn't. So if you guys want to see a bonus video on everything that I do like, head over to my Instagram channel and DM me the word bonus, and I'll make the video over there. So basically, all of the items that I talk about today, there are items that I replaced it with that I can talk about over there on my Instagram channel. And I know that a lot of you guys do follow me and comment and send me messages, which I do love. So let's keep the party rolling over there as well. I'll make sure to leave my Instagram name or handle over here just in case you guys are not following me. Come on, you already know you should be subscribing and following me on Instagram and here on YouTube. But without rambling, without continuing, let's jump right into this video. So the first item that I have to mention is this one. This is Terre de Hermes. It is very iconic and classic for the brand. It costs $130, and the notes in it are like grapefruit and citrus, and it's very woodsy, and it also has hints of patchouli in it. And that's why, honestly, I was gravitating towards it. But then I found it that everybody had this fragrance, and it almost always smells like an older gentleman on me, like a grandfather or someone in the older gentleman category. I specifically remember this fragrance that I went to my holiday party at my company, and my boss's husband wore this scent, because this scent is very distinctive. When somebody has this scent on, you smell it. You know exactly what it is. So he had this scent on, and it was like he got all sloppy. So this, like, so it always reminds me of someone who is, you know, who likes to have fun, an older guy who likes to have fun, likes to go and drinks their old fashions and drinks a little bit too much and gets a little sloppy, but they're still pulled together, if that makes sense to you. That's exactly what this fragrance reminds me of. And as you can see, I barely used it. I probably sprayed this like maybe once or twice, because every time I smell this, it just reminds me of him, and it reminds me of an older guy, and it reminds me like of just something that I don't want to smell like. So as of right now, I do not use this, and that is probably the reason why. But I feel like maybe when I get older and my notes and my nose changes and my scent changes, maybe I might use it. So right now, it's right back there sitting all the way in the back. So sadly, the first item that I have to mention is this one, the Terre de Hermes. This is how it looks, and also has like the iconic H at the bottom. But yeah, sorry, Hermes. So the next item that I have to talk about is this one. As you can see, I literally love this electric blue color. It's definitely one of my favorites. But just because this color is my favorite, I still don't gravitate towards this book, nor do I use it. So this is the Ulysses notebook, the PM size by Hermes. So now I just feel like I don't use it because I'm so scared to like scratch it up or to ruin the leather of this book. And it is literally just a piece of leather that you get, and you have to also buy this notebook. I'm pretty sure that I did a review on it, or I talked about it, so I'll make sure to link the video up here or down in the description box. But it costs, I think, $310 or something around that price range, and I just don't use it. I feel like it's too fancy of a notebook, and I always write things down. I'm old school like that, where I just have to write down my thoughts or my notes if I'm thinking about something. And this one, I just feel like I don't use it, and I'm pretty sure in every video you probably see it sitting right here somewhere on top of everything. And I just feel like I just like it more as in a decor item versus as in actually using it. I think I just literally keep like invitations in here, notes that my SA wrote to me, this little book, business cards, and I wrote like my wish list in here. And even then, I have another piece of paper that I just stuck in the notebook. So I mostly just use it as like a notebook where I put things in versus an actual notebook. You can go ahead and buy this, but I don't use it. I feel like you can be good without it. And you can save that $310 or whatever that money towards something else. But here it is, the Ulysses notebook by Hermes. So the next item that I want to talk about comes in this box. Can you guys guess what it is? It's kind of sad making this video, but you know, I gotta keep it real with you guys. I gotta really tell you guys, either get it or don't get it, because I want you guys to save your money and not waste it. But anyway, I digress. It is this Kelly double tour bracelet. I got it in the black with the gold hardware. It cost $510, and at the time I was obsessed with this bracelet, but I never used it, if that makes sense. I probably got like maybe a hand, maybe two handful wear out of this bracelet. I just feel like it is very awkward because the top part over here, it is just very awkwardly sticking out, and it gets hooked onto everything. When you're walking and shopping, it gets hooked onto the clothes. When you're wearing your clothes, it gets hooked into your sweater and rips your sweater. You know how much sweaters this damn bracelet ripped? You know how much times like it got banged? But I just feel like it sticks up way too high for it to be a bracelet. I just think that they should probably rethink this design. It is very nice in a belt, and it's very nice on the bags, but as a bracelet, it's just very awkward. Like, my favorite bracelet, again, is a little sneak peek of what I'm gonna be talking about on my Instagram, is this CDC. Like, it does, the pyramids do stick out, but it doesn't stick out so high, and it is very flat. But this one, it sticks out, and it's like a hook at the top, so it gets caught in everything. So that is really the number one reason why I don't wear this bracelet. Again, I'm still obsessed with it. I just don't like it anymore. I just feel like, oh, there's so many other bracelets that I can get instead of wearing this one. Let me see if I can put it. Let me see if I want to wear it for the rest of this video. Now it's on. So maybe I'll wear it for the rest of this video just because I can say I wore it. But yeah, I don't wear it. This probably sits right up there with everything else that I do not use. But again, the Kelly Double Tour Bracelet, $510. Make sure you try it on. Make sure you definitely really try it on. Walk around the store with it on. See how you like it. You know, try to put on your jacket or your sweater and then see if it gets caught into anything. And if it doesn't, and if you like it, and if it works for you, go ahead and get it. But if not, just say no. So the next couple of items I really never ever wore. One still has a tag on it and the other never came with a tag, but I just don't use it. And it comes in this small box, and here it is. I don't know if you guys remember this, but this is the ornament that I got, the ornament slash bag charm that I got from the Petite Ash when it came to New York. Now, you guys already know the Petite Ash is when they take like Hermes leathers or Hermes hardwares or Hermes anything and make it into something else, which I think is a very cool idea. It's like recycled Hermes products. So this leather could have came from a Birkin or a Kelly or a bag or anything, and they repurposed it and made it into like this little angel ornament. And this top part is silk, so it could probably came from a silk scarf or a silk any item that they have, and they made this out of it, and it is really, really cool. But I just feel like I never use it. I feel like now, maybe now since it's Christmas, I probably should put it on my Christmas tree. I don't know yet, but here it is. It is this angel. It features two of my favorite colors, the gold, and the gold is in this Togo leather, and no, sorry, the gold part is in this Epsom leather, and this Etan is in this Togo leather. And I freaking love these two leathers, so this is probably why I got it, but I never use it. Maybe I should start using it. Maybe I should pin it on my Christmas tree or hang it from something so I can use it. Again, I don't even know how much that one cost. It was a special item. I have no idea how much that cost, and I hope I didn't pay a lot of money for that item, because I ain't using it. But I'm gonna try to use it, people. I'm gonna try to use it, so calm down. So the next item I'm about to show you guys, I really never, ever, ever use. And if you guys have been following my channel for a very long time, you already know what it is. And it comes in this box. Can you guys guess what it is? And dun da da da, here it is, this Hermes silk scarf. It costs $395, and you would think, because I never used this one, why should I buy more? But no, I bought like three more of them, but I do use one of them, and the other two are more of a collector's item that I want to use as artwork in my house. But anyway, here it is, the scarf. This is a Pegasus one. This is the first one that I ever bought. This is the first scarf that I ever bought from Hermes, and I love the colors in it. Like, look at this. It shows a Pegasus horse head. Let me see if I can give it to you right. And it's like this. This is the right way, if you guys can see it. It's like this prism art deco, which I love. And again, like I said, I'm not even lying. Look the tag still on it. This is ridiculous. And I just don't know how to wear it. Maybe that's why I haven't worn it yet. And this feels so luxurious, people. Like, it is definitely, like, the best silk that I've ever felt in my life. It is really, really good. But I don't know how to use it. So, I'll figure it out. But again, this is an item that I really do not, never, ever use. I'm going to try to use it. So I'm probably going to get a lot of comments saying, why don't you sell these items? Why don't you do this? Why don't you do this? And I feel like I'm not going to sell any of these items. I'm going to try to repurpose it and try to find a way for it in my life. And then if I do not really, really find a way for it, and if you guys want to buy it or somebody wants to buy it, I'll sell it to them. Because again, I'd rather get rid of it and then bring something in that I really, really do want and really, really do use. Okay, people? So try to figure out a way for you to use it before you sell it. You know what? This is why am I rambling? Nico, shut up. You're just rambling so much. Shut up. So the next item probably will come as a shock to you guys. And it comes in this little box. And I'll give you guys a hint. Do you hear it? And it is the Hermes Bastia. So funny thing about this item, like, I've always wanted this item. I just love how, you know, it's made. Like, you can just pour your change out and it comes into this little pocket and you can really see and pick out the change that you really need. But you know what? My essay was right. She told me, you do not need this item, nor are you going to use it. But I was like, yo, you don't know what you're talking about. You don't know what you're talking about. And I got it anyway from someone else. And she was so right. She was so right that I do not use this item at all because I don't carry change. I don't carry change on me. Every time that I do get change, I keep my change. But when I come home, I have this like little change bucket that I just empty out all the change in because I'm like, you know what? I don't like walking around with a bunch of little clankling, clankling, clankling all around. So I just take that money and put it into my little change jar when I get home. And therefore, there is no need for this. I rather have purchased the Calvi. Again, this is what's going to be in a bonus video, so make sure you guys stay tuned for that bonus video, but I'll give you a little sneak peek again. I should have purchased the Calvi, which is more of a rectangular shape, which can fit cash and your cards in. And you guys already know I love card cases. I probably have a dozen of them already, but I should never got this one. I should have listened to her. You know what? You were right, Hermes SA. If you're watching this video, you was right. And last but not least, this item will come as a shock to you guys, and it comes in this box. Do you guys recognize what this box may be? And let's look at it together. And I'm kind of half lying because I don't hate this entire kit. I just specifically hate this part of the kit. And I specifically knew I should have never got this H because I do not like logos all over my items. I like more of a subdued logo versus this type of H on your belt. Like, everybody knows what this stands for, and I'd rather have something that makes people think and ask questions instead of just automatically assuming knowing what it is. But you know what? I digress. And if you have the belt, more power to you. I'm not hating on you. Again, these are all my own opinions. If you have all of these items, don't think I'm hating on you. Don't think I'm shitting on any of your items. I am just telling you what I feel of my own opinions of what I like and what I don't like. And again, I hope you guys take that into consideration when buying your next item, and I also hope that this video helped you guys out a lot. So definitely make sure you do your research and make sure you guys try the items out in the store as much as possible before you pull the trigger and buy it, because you will regret it if you buy something and you cannot return it. Especially from Hermes, you cannot return anything from Hermes. You can just get store credit. And that's all I got for you beautiful people today. I hope you like this video. And again, go over to my Instagram channel and comment on bonus if you guys want the bonus video that I can talk about over there. And I'm also going to be doing like a lot of YouTube, Instagram videos and collaborations with each other. So this all makes sense and it all, you know, goes back to each other. So without further ado, I hope you beautiful people have an amazing day. Peace. Bye.